As we have rolled out the beta launch for the GCP monitoring, we have rolled out for monitoring around 8 services in GCP, including the compute engine and Kubernetes engines in the compute domain. Similarly, file store and storage in the storage domain. Similarly, cloud interconnect and no VPC network and cloud router in the network domain. And then, of course, the billing service. So these are the 8 services that we have launched as part of our beta release in the last month. So while the data collection happens through the RESTMON probe in UIM for GCP monitoring, it's also equally important that how we present this data for better triage and then for generating these dashboards for the stakeholders to give a kind of a summary report of how the monitoring is happening, where is systems that require an attention, right? So this dashboard has been created as an out of the box dashboard. We are working towards publishing the guidelines on how this particular dashboard has been created, which can definitely help the customers, to create or use this dashboard or customize it based on the needs and based on the landscape of systems that are present in their GCP environment, right? I'll quickly go through how this dashboard has been created. I'm sure some of you are already aware of this. At a very top level, when it comes to the dashboard designer, we talk about two things. The first thing is the widgets, and second thing is the data sources, right? So we use the widgets for rendering a particular model with respect to, okay, whether we need a pie chart or whether we need a data list, whether we need a line chart, right? So those kind of displays will help us to render the data in a way that we can present it in the dashboards, right? So once the widgets have been selected, right, it's very important that how we present the data, right? And it's very important that we select the right widgets for the right data sources. As an example, in this summary dashboard, it started with an widget of pie chart, which is actually telling that, okay, so these are the list of alarms that are raised by the GCP monitoring probe, that is through RESTMON, but how much percentage of those alarms are critical and how many are major, right? So this is driven through a simple pie chart. And if you select this and get into the data source, right? So it's a very simple query from our own NAS alarms table. And all that we are doing is, what is the count of the alarms which are raised by GCP across all the probes, all the 8 services that we are talking about, and we are just grouping it based on the severity, right? So the color codes of the pie charts have been enhanced recently to make it in line with what the alarm color codes requires, right? Because it requires deep red for critical, light red for major, orange for minor. So we ensured that these color codes have been adjusted so that a proper pie chart to display the alarms by severity can be embedded within the dashboard, right? And similarly, because we are talking about a summary view of a GCP, right, will be interesting that, okay, how many compute engines are being monitored, right? Again, so this is a simple widget, which is again driven through a data source. So we are working towards publishing these data sources as well as part of our documentation. So you need not actually search for these data sources. You can directly, use these data sources and then directly drag and drop onto the widgets that you want to see in your dashboard, right? So this widget has been created with the list of count of compute engines. And then you can see a small data source icon over here, which is nothing but, are there any alarms that are raised on the compute engines, right? So all that has to be done over here is get into the alarm section into the data source, right? Alarms on GC, and if the probe is GC compute engine, then it tells it, okay, all the alarms, if there are any alarms that are raised by GCP compute engine, right? And the maximum severity will be displayed in this icon, right? Similar way for Kubernetes engines, storage. So we are actually taking the count first, and then we are attaching a data source icons with respect to the alarms just to show the health of each of these services. And if you go slightly to the right, so this is an example for a line chart, which talks about what is the billing, right? How much is being billed, for each of these services, right? So here in this example, I have created the line chart with three series, one for Compute Engine, Kubernetes, second for Kubernetes Engine, third for BigQuery. So we can have the other services as well, and then we can have the line series for other services which are consuming the billing aspect, right? All right, and then SLA integration, right? So while we use SLM for creating the SLA reports, right? So Dashboard Designer has a very good feature with respect to the SLA integration. So any SLAs that are created through SLM, right? So those will be available as data sources. Okay, as you can see over here, these are the list of SLAs that have been created. Simply drag and drop the SLA onto the widget. You'll see the system availability that is generated by the SLA report directly on this widget, right? So, all right. So that's about, you know, the header section of this dashboard. While this talks about the summary, okay, so this is the summary of alarms, this is the summary of the inventory, this is the summary of the billing, right? What if you want to deep dive into each of these services, right? So there are some sample widgets that have been created. For Compute Engine, as you can see, there are 66 instances over here. You know, this list widget has been created with all those 66 instances. The way we have rolled out the GCP is it has the ability to auto group the devices. This list widget is something that has been created based on the group that has been auto created. The main point to understand over here is we go with the list when we want to see the snapshot of the cost measurements. For suppose, if I want to see the CPU utilization at a given point of time for all the list of devices, you can go for the list view. But for suppose on the VPC network monitoring, as you can see, we have only three VPC entities over here. List view may not really give better usability, but it's better to go with the series because we have only three VPC networks. So what we have done is we have actually leveraged the context selector in the dashboard designer, where all the three VPC networks can be shown. Let me go to the live view. Okay, and then you can select any of the VPC network, and then you can see how many bytes have been received, how many bytes have been sent, similarly packets received and packets sent, and then you can have a custom time range, right? So this is driven through the context selector. And again, storage monitoring, because number of systems are high, you know, it's better to put a snapshot of how much you know, size each of the buckets or each of the objects within this storage is being occupied, and what is the object count within these storage entities, right? So these widgets, the one below the summary, so these are like a deep dive of what we are displaying in the summary over here, right? So this is how some of the dashboards can be created using the dashboard designer in UAM. Similar logic or similar kind of framing can also be applied for you know, other technologies like SQL Server, Azure, AWS, any of the technologies, right? But the core standards are, you know, the widgets and the data sources. Create the right widgets to display the right data sources. So that's the key point over here.